वेलकम बैक। सो हियर दिस इज़ द कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ द लास्ट पार्ट टू। ओके, सो ब्रशलेस डीसी मोटर ड्राइव्स। सो ऑलरेडी आई हैव डिस्कस द ब्रशलेस डीसी मोटर। ओके, कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वर्किंग आई हैव डिस्कस। ओके, लेट अस बिगन विद द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ ट्रेपेजॉइडल पीएमएसी मोटर। Okay, so here, okay, so in this, it has permanent magnet rotor with wide pole arc. Okay, wide pole arc. We are looking here the rotor. Okay, this is the wide pole arc. Okay, permanent magnet. Okay, the stator has the three concentrated phase windings. Okay, so here three concentrated phase windings, okay, which are displaced by 120 degree, and each phase winding span is 60 degree on each side. So it means here the 60 degree it will be here and 60 degree it will be here. Okay, I repeat here, the which are displaced by 120 degree and each phase winding spans 60 degree on each side. Now the voltage induced, I will show you here the waveform. Okay, so the voltage induced in the three phase, the EA, EB and EC. I repeat here, when the supply, pulsed supply here, because inverter we are using. I will show you that circuit diagram also. Okay, so when you are exciting, the pulsed supply to the stator, what it will be happens, the EMF induced in the stator EA, okay, EA, EB and EC. So here, if you are looking to these waveforms, the induced EMF in the stator, okay, so what it is there? It is a trapezoidal waveform. If you are looking to this waveform, trapezoidal, so E phase, B phase and C phase. Okay, hence these motors are called trapezoidal PMAC motor. I repeat here, trapezoidal PMAC. Means the earlier one we are seen on the sinusoidal. So there what it will be happens, the sinusoidal it will be appears. Okay, hence the name is called a trapezoidal PMAC motor. Please note it. Okay, now the circuit I will show you how it is connected here. Okay, now the here six transistors are used. Okay, and the DC is powered here. I will, okay, this is our input DC and these are the switches, six switches transistors, and the each phase is connected to the RYB. Okay, here ABC notation is taken into consideration. Okay, ABC, and this is the stator wind. Okay, stator coil of PMAC motor. Okay, brushless DC motor. Okay, now this I will discuss later. Okay, so if the question is asked, the trapezoidal PMAC motor means you have to explain about the how the switching is done. You have to plot this first. You have to plot this circuit diagram. Okay, and this I will explain anyhow. This is also is important, and the waveforms which I earlier I discussed, the trapezoidal waveforms. Okay, now I will discuss the working, how it will be works. So okay, this I explain. Okay, now okay, so here the voltage induced in phase A will be the same during 120 degree rotation. Okay, The wave voltage induces in phase linearly reverses in next 60 degree rotation. Okay, this is two very important point. Note it. What it is, the voltage induced in phase A will be the same during 120 degree rotation, and the reverse is in next 60 degree rotation. Okay, so here I will go back and I will show you. If you are looking to this, okay, voltage induces in phase A will be the same during 120 degree. Okay, 120 degree it will be same. Next 60 degree, what it will be is there, the voltage induces in phase a linearly reverses in next 60 degree rotation. Here if you are coming to the here, it will be rotation again, it will be remains for 60 degree. See how to plot the waveform. You should remember here, first you have to make it the waveforms 60 degree each. Okay, in each 60 degree division you have to make it, and 120 degree you have to show that the induced EMF, okay, induced EMF in induced voltage in phase A will be the same with 120 degree, and next 60 degree what it will be happens, next 60 degree linearly it will be reverses, linearly it will be reverses, again it will be goes to the this one 120 degree, and again it will be reverses to the here. Because why it is means as the working we are seeing the rotor in this position. Okay, so when it will be comes to the next linearly it will what it will be happens, the polarity of the excitation of coil it will be reverses. Okay, so hence the voltage will be reverses. So coming to the second B phase, if you are looking to the B phase, it is also same only. Okay, what it will be happens, if you are looking this portion 120 to the here 240, okay, so 120 degree, again it is 120 degree, and next 60 degree linearly reverses, again it will becomes 120 degree. Similarly C, so in exam what we have to do, explanation, only one part you have to explain, only one part you have to explain, and conclude that similarly the voltage induces in the phase B and C. Okay, so it will be similarly, it will be the voltage will be induces in the B and C, like that you can conclude it. No need to explain this separately. One EA you have to explain, EA is nothing but the induced voltage. Okay, so the voltage induces in the phase A. Okay, now next, so here the few points we have to explain here. Here this inverter is called a 6-step inverter because the 6 switches are used here. The naming is given here, 1 okay, 6, 4. So total here 6 are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here the next point is, the first point is, 6-step inverter is used to generate the 3-phase supply, and the electronic commutation between the 3 pairs of stator coils needed to provide the rotating field. So which it will be provides the rotating field to this stator. Okay, so rotating field will be used when you are exciting the stator. I hope first point is clear. A 6-step inverter is used to generate the 3-phase supply. Okay, and second point is only 2 out of 3 pole pairs are energized at any one time. So in the last video lecture I have shown the animated video, so we are energizing any 2 out of 3 pole pairs. Okay, 2 pole pairs we are energizing. We have seen here A1, A2 it was there, okay, then B1, B2 and C1, C2. Okay, so any 2 pairs we are energizing, so that rotor in this position is there in initial. Now I want to bring to the in this position, so what I have to do, A1, A2 I will remove and I will give the B1 and B2. It means what? Only two out of three pole pairs. Three pole pairs means A1, A2 one pair, B1, B2 second pair, C1, C2 third pair. So total how many pair we have? Three pole pairs. Out of three pole pairs, we are giving only two pairs. Okay, only two. Okay, only two means A1, A2. If I am giving means this is one pair. Okay. I hope it is clear, no? So I conclude here that only two out of three pole pairs are energized at any one time. This also means that only two of the six inverter switches are conducting. It means what? It means what? At any instant, we can say that the only two transistors, okay, only two transistors are operating at any that instant. Means the, when you are applying for the this two, A1, A2 or B1, B2 or C1, C2, at that state, the switches is nothing but here transistors, okay, are conducting at any one time, okay, two switches only, okay. So the speed of rotation is controlled by the pulse frequency and the torque by the pulse current. Okay. So it means what? The rotation we can control by giving this the pulse frequency and the torque by the pulse current depending upon the to the stator only, huh? To the stator only. In practice, the system needs some fairly complex electronics to provide the electronic commutations. So some commutations is required to give the circuits is required here. So now the current waveform little I will explain here. Waveform current I will go and I will explain. Okay, so here if we are looking to this ID, okay, the current it will be flows during between 0 to 180 degree. This is 180 degree, sorry, 120 degree here. I will take, okay. So here the current which it will be flows 120 degree. Why means where the excitation will be done during this 120 degree only. Previously, I have explained about these things, okay. So, because if you are looking to the induced voltage also during this period only, you can go and see here. I will come to the, this is IA, okay. IA is nothing but EA. I have to see here. You see, okay. So, this is okay, if I am taking this, so what it is the 60 degree, sorry, 120 degree. 120 degree, okay. The current it will be flows. ID current means the source current it will be, okay. Main DC current what it will be flows, that is ID current, okay. Okay. So here it will be how it will be flows, and I will explain here one more circuit I put nearly. So slides I put here and there so that what it we have to do, the explanation I am going through the best possible to convince. I am going to the few of the slides I am skipping and I am going, okay. Finally, I will conclude all these slides. What are the points are there, okay. So coming to the this, okay. So here in this, the during the period between 0 degree to the 60 degree, okay. So what it will be happens, IA is equal to ID, okay. ID means this is current, okay. This current what it will be flows here from the source to the inverter, okay. Input current, okay, it will be goes to the at any during the 60 degree. IA is equal to ID and IB is equal to minus ID, okay. And the current IA enters through the phase A and leaves through the phase B when transistor TR1 and TR6 are on. So here TR1 is this one because it is enters here, okay, and it will be goes to the phase A, okay, and TR6 are on. TR6 means this B phase, it will becomes to the here, and okay, so it will becomes here to the, I hope it is clear. I repeat here what it is. The current IA enters through the phase A and leaves through the phase B when transistor TR1 and TR6 are on. Okay. Now what it will be happens? Terminal A is connected to the where it is connected. Just you have to go through back here, and this is on means it is shorted here. Okay. It will be connected to the positive terminal. I repeat here, terminal A is connected to the positive, and whereas the terminal B means here the terminal B, because the current will be flows through the A to the B. Okay, it is enters A, leaves B, and B where it is connected, you go through this line and come to the here. Transistor 6 is on. 6 is on means what it will be happens? It is a like a shorted, right? And it will be connected to the where? Negative. So I conclude here that the terminal A is connected to the positive terminal of the source VD, okay, and the B is connected to the negative terminal of the DC source. Okay, a current will flow through the path consisting of VD. I will clear once I will conclude here. Okay, the current will flow through the path consisting of VD, then where it will be goes? Transistor 1, TR1, then it will be goes to the phase A, and it enters here and coming out to B, and where it goes, it will be goes to the TR6 and back to the supply. Okay, so here during this what it will be happens, the current for 120 degree excitation, okay, so 120 degree, and the waveform I have to go and I have to explain anyhow. I will go back. Here you can see, so the when it is given a current ID, it will be flows 120 degree, okay, IA current. So this is the IA current. So what it is there, ID, it will be flows during between 0 to 120 degree. Okay, similarly what it is there, IB will get, IC will get. So here the concept of positive current I have explained. The current, it will be fluctuates between the upper band and lower band. So what it is there, here the current has to flow against voltage VD, the rate of change of IA will be the negative. Thus by alternately turning on and off transistor TR1 and TR6, okay, so the phase A current can be made to flow the reference current ID within a hysteresis band. So what it is there, we have to make the DC, okay, so recall it, this ID, it is there, ID means where I am seeing means, just I will go back and I will show you. So here, if you are looking to the here, okay, it should be a DC current. Right, it should be a DC current. How I will make this DC current? This hysteresis band, it will be gives a idea about the current. Okay, so here what it is there, the turning on of the transistor 1 and 6, because just now I have explained the transistor TR1 and TR6, it will be turning on. Okay, so what it will be happens, the current it will be flows, current it will be flows between these two bands, so upper and lower band. So here the current will be fluctuating between the upper band and lower band. Okay, so by reducing the band sufficiently nearly, a DC current of desired value can be produced, so that we can reduce this band. So what the width of this band is there, if you are reducing, okay, so that how it is possible to reduce, by making the turning on and off of the switch, it will be very fast. So that if I am turning on and off, okay, because it is turning on and this is off. So if I am plotting here, okay, if okay, so this is a reference line. Okay, once again I will draw. Okay, so here the turning on and off, if I am making turning on and off, turning on and off, turning on and off, see the band I am reduced here. Okay, so that what it will be happens, by reducing the band sufficiently, okay, nearly a DC current, okay, nearly a DC current value can be produced. Okay, so next point I will explain here, some rotor position. Finally I will explain this slide. Okay, finally I will explain. So before, I will go back, some torque equation I will show you. Okay, this is okay. Okay. So here the current pulses are each 120 degree duration and are located in the region where induced voltage is constant and maximum. This is very important, because we want constant and it should be a maximum, so that rotor it will be rotates with smoothly and with the high torque. Okay, further the polarity of current pulses is the same as that of induced voltage. Okay, the polarity of current pulses is the same as that of induced voltage. Since the air gap flux is constant, okay, air gap flux is constant, the voltage induced is proportional to the speed of rotor. Okay, so that E is equal to KE omega m. Okay, now during each 60 degree interval, okay, during each 60 degree interval, the currents enters one phase and comes out of another phase. Just now I have discussed what it is, the current will be enters in the A phase and coming out from the B phase. Therefore, the power supplied to the motor in each interval. So each interval, what it will be happens, E into ID, okay, plus minus E into minus ID. Why it is minus E means, because it will be loose, means it will be come out from the phase. So the one is positive and the other one is negative. So what it will be happens, if you are adding, you will get the 2E ID. Okay. So now substitute in the above equation, so that we will get the 2KE omega m ID. Okay, now here KE omega m, I substituted here. Okay, KE omega m ID, E is equal to this, E is equal to substituting here in place of E, in place of E, so what it will be happens, 2 as it is KE omega m ID. So now the torque developed by the motor, as you know, the product of speed and torque is equal to power developed by the motor. Okay, so here T is equal to P by omega m. So P, if I am substituting this, I will get KT is equal to ID, so that torque is directly proportional to the ID. I want to conclude here, this is a very important point, the torque is directly proportional to the ID. So hence we are getting the here the torque is, according to the above equation, torque is proportional to the ID. So it can be shown in the DC current ID flows in the DC link. Okay, this is the torque will be remains constant over all the angle over the 360 degree. Okay, so now this I explained. Okay, anything else I will see. Okay, so the last point related to the this one is related to the sensor, because to excitation it will be done, stator excitation will be sequence, the sequence of excitation of stator is very important, because the rotor it will be moves accordingly, so that we should sense the position of the rotor. So hence here the okay, as I told, the sensors are mounted at a 60 degree electrical interval, okay, aligned suitable with the stator winding. So the sensors are placed with 60 degree. This is one point was there. Okay, important features and applications. Okay, final application I will go. So here, so this point I will discuss. I hope everything is have completed. Okay, now so some of the features and advantages we will see. Okay, so what it is there, due to the absence of the brushless and commutator, brushless DC motor drives has a number of advantages compared to the conventional DC motor, because the absence of brushes. Okay, they require practically no maintenance, have long life, have reliability, low inertia and friction, low radio frequency interference and noise. Due to low inertia and friction, they have a faster acceleration. This is also very important, because the less inertia and less friction, the less this one faster acceleration, and can be run at much higher speed. Okay, so up to this much RPM. And because armature windings are on the stator, cooling is much better. Higher specific output can be obtained. These motors have high efficiency, exceeding 75%, whereas wound filled motors of low power rating have much lower efficiency. The disadvantages compared to the conventional DC motor are high cost and low starting torque. Okay, the size of the brushless DC motor is nearly the same as of the conventional DC motor. So here the brushless DC motor drives finds application in video recorder, hard disk drive for computers, applications in aerospace, biomedical, okay, drying cooling fans for electronic circuit and heat sinks. Okay, these are the application. Just try to go through. Okay, so with this I conclude this lecture session. Okay, thank you.